Japanese people are one of the most intelligent and the most disciplined people that we have in our entire world. But once they take something to their ego, that's when things get really competitive. It all started in 1996 when Honda came out with the Blackbird, only with the objective to beat the ZX-11 in terms of top speed. In its peak form, the Blackbird would do 289 kilometers at that time, making it the world's fastest bike. But 2 years later, Suzuki came out with the amazing Hayabusa. It had a top speed of 312 kilometers an hour, and that made it the first bike that would ever cross the 300 kilometer mark, as well as to make it the world's fastest bike. Now obviously Kawasaki was not going to shy away from the competition, because they were the ones who came up with the entire speed wars, and that is when they came out with a banger of a motorcycle. In 2006, Kawasaki dropped a huge bomb in the superbike market with this, the Kawasaki ZX-14R. The 14R is capable of touching a whopping top speed of 335 kilometers an hour. But due to a gentleman's agreement by the Japanese motorcycle companies, these bikes were electronically limited to 299 kilometers an hour.
Now, obviously, if you want something to create enough thrust like this bike does, you need to have an equally powerful engine. This motorcycle right here, it has a huge 1,441cc liquid-cooled 16-valve DOHC engine, which produces 220 brake horsepower at the crank and a maximum torque of 158 Newton meters. Now, if you ask me, that sounds enough to rip the tarmac off of the road.
There's no doubt that the 14R is a super fast bike. And when you've got something this fast, and when you're dropping the anchor, boy oh boy, you're in for a treat. The 310mm double disc up front, powered by the Nissan calipers, are super strong. Kawasaki employs the usage of rubber lines in their braking, so when you start initially braking, it has a nice soft bite. The rear at the same time is powered by a pretty massive 240mm disc, powered by Nissan as well. Let's just step back and take a look at the motorcycle. It is for a fact that you are not going to see anything designed like this on our roads today, or maybe for the next 10 years in fact. Let's start off with the front. It has a huge ram air intake over here. At the sides, you've got huge air channels that channel the air throughout the bike, which makes it much more aerodynamic. This entire bike has been shaped in the wind tunnel only for the purpose of aerodynamics. You've got curves, you've got slight edges, you've got a very thick body and a very thick panel on the motorcycle, which makes it look super bulky and also makes you feel that you're scared. And that is exactly what the ZX-14R portrays. ZX-14R is an experience like no other. You sit super low and tucked in. Once you lean down and twist the throttle, the bike grips onto the road like hot glue and launches you straight into hyperspeed. It feels as if the bike can rip a hole through time and space. The 14R was designed to trump the Busa in each and every way, including a lot of factors. The body is much more compact. It's shorter than the Busa in terms of length and is a little bit wider. It has a better heat management system, and the rear suspension is easier to set up. All of this makes the ZX14R a downright Hayabusa killer. We can say for sure that the ZX14R is a phenomenal motorcycle. It has everything that you could ask for. You've got superb braking, amazing power, a huge engine, and all in all, a very scary look. But as I'm talking about this, it hurts me to tell you that this bike has now been discontinued by Kawasaki. They will be taking their last orders and they will be delivered in the month of March in the year of 2020. This bike has shown us that they can be super powerful and they can touch hyper speeds. But at the end of the day, even though it is something scary, you will still hold it very close to your heart. I would like to thank Aces, a club of elite superbikers, for lending us their two most prized possessions. And I urge you to follow their Instagram page if you are somebody who loves superbikes. Subscribe to our channel, watch our videos, like them as well. And if you think that we can improve in some way, or if you want us to do something that you think would be a really good video, please let us know in the comments.